please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
To the show, Mahanagar Gas is one stock that has been in a focus after the PNGRB chairman told CNBC TV18 that they are inviting new bids for city gas distribution. SM Ranade, the CFO of the company, joins us now. Mr. Ranade, can you tell us about a little bit about the auction that's expected to take place for gas distribution? Have you heard anything at all? There was an expectation that this would happen around this time period itself, between the 18th to 20th of April.
Yeah, good morning, and yes, definitely we have heard about it. There is a official notification by our regulator, the PNGRB. Almost 86 geographical areas now have been put up for bidding, and this is a good news for the entire city gas distribution industry. Also, on the positive side, they have amended certain regulations with respect to these bidding areas. And there are clearly positive signs that there will be encouraging results coming up on the CGD front.
Will you, Mr. Ranade, be bidding for more for cities other than what you already have now, Mumbai and others? Do we see you in other cities in a year or so?
Sure, definitely. We are open, in fact, on pan-India basis. The only thing we'll be doing is, it's not that entire 86 GAs which will be offered that we'll be bidding for each and every area. The company will be selective. We have certain financial as well as non-financial parameters, like maybe project IRR, NPV size, etc. on financial front. There are certain other factors, the what kind of population density you have, or what kind of customer category combination you have in different geographies. All these areas will be taken into consideration, notwithstanding the fact that whatever value we have so far created in Mumbai and around region, we will definitely like to keep those value created intact. And in addition to that, we will definitely be looking up for the additional areas.
Okay. Mr. Ranade, good morning. What's the view on pricing? Because recently we've had a couple of price hikes. Gujarat Gas, I think, had hiked prices. I think Adani had hiked prices. From MGL's point of view, have you also taken a price hike, or are you looking at that?
We have already taken the price rise similar to other companies. In fact, with effect from 1st April, the price rise was considered by us and already implemented. This was for the simple reason that for CNG and domestic household categories, we get domestically produced gas. And the price of that domestically produced gas had gone up based on the formula set by the central government. As a result, the basic intention was to pass through this gas cost, and hence this most of the CGD companies had come out with the price rise.
So what are we looking at in terms of volumes? Because over the last, say, 5 years, your company has seen a volume growth compounded of about 5-6%. Given that there is so much improvement as far as the sector prospects are concerned, what are you looking at in terms of volume growth?
I think we do look at what we have been maintaining always is around 6% growth on a 5-yearly CAGR basis. Last quarter Q3 we did better as compared to previous quarter. In the previous year we achieved around 7%, but there was some element of base effect involved due to demonetization also. That apart, but we still continue to maintain that we should grow at a 6% odd on the CAGR basis over a period of 5 years. But this is business as normal. There could be many other positive triggers which can then definitely increase this rate.
Currently, what is your EBITDA per unit of gas, per SCM, say?
I think we can talk about the figures which are available in public domain. When we declared Q3 results, It was approximately 8 rupees per SCM. This is what was the EBITDA in Q3 results which we have seen.
You don't see it falling, do you?
See, the EBITDA or margins are a function of sales realization on one side and cost on the other side. Cost includes gas costs as well as OPEX. We have to probably admit that this financial year 17-18, the at least 9 months period which we have already seen, almost all the factors which are impacting margins have been favorable to us. However, even going forward, let us talk about suppose sales realizations. If we talk about the sales realization in industrial and commercial front, since the oil price levels are going up, the prices of alternate fuels like LSHs, FO, etc. will also go up. And to that extent, I think our net realizations, there is a chance will improve in industrial and commercial customer segment. Whereas in case of CNG and domestic, since petrol and diesel prices are increasing, it augurs well for the company from near sales realization point of view for CNG as well as domestic customer segment. And as regards gas cost, I think we should be able to pass through, which we have done in the past also, and even recently we have been able to pass through the gas cost in priority segment, that is CNG and domestic.
Okay, but you know, the stock has been under pressure this year. It's down almost 20%, and the concern is the promoter selling that we've seen. BG Asia has recently sold about 12.5% of their stake. Is there more promoter selling that you know, we could see in the company?
I think number one, this is a prerogative of promoter or the shareholder we are talking about. So question probably can be best answered by the promoters or the shareholder itself. But that apart, probably when you are posing this question to Mahanagar Gas, what you may have in mind is what are the implications for MGL or what could be the impact on MGL. If that is the case which we are talking about, I think there is absolutely nothing to worry from company point of view. MGL is a board managed independent company. We have a proven track record in city gas distribution. We are a technically sound company, financially sound company. So I think we have been doing business well, and business will continue as normal. Absolutely nothing to worry as such.
Yes, Mrs. Anade, point taken. As a user of, you know, of course, your product in Mumbai, all of us, we can vouch for that. Thanks a lot for your time today. That's Mahanagar Gas. Mindtree's management is almost getting ready. Before that, let's quickly take some trades. Ashwini Gujral, Mitesh Thakkar back with us. Rajat Bose is also with us. Ashwini, your thoughts on the first hour of trade, and what about the individual stock call?
See, first hour is according to expectation. I expected, you know, the lows of Bank Nifty to hold. So if you went short in the morning, you're getting some profit right now. I think you can cover. We have covered, and we are now long, because I expect that since the 70%, 80% of the market is positive and you have an expiry, it's quite likely if the lows hold, you will have a reversal on the Bank Nifty fairly soon. So that way, you know, now long positions can be assumed. The stop is low of the day. As far as individual stocks are concerned, Balrampur Chini is a sell with a stop of 74, target of 62. HPCL remains a sell with a stop of 315, target of 300. And Vedanta is a buy with a stop of 296, target of 310.
Okay, Mitesh Thakkar and Rajat Bose are also with us. So let's get their strategies very quickly. Mitesh, morning. What are you looking to buy or sell now?
I think the crude prices have fired some movement in ONGC, and that's looking positive. So buy with a stop at 183, look for targets of 190, 194. And Torrent Pharma, I think the traction is clearly happening on the upside. So 1350 is the recommended stop loss, and this one can be bought for targets of 1400.
Okay. Rajat, good morning to you. What would you trade?
Good morning. I'm buying two stocks, ZTV and Sun TV. Buy with a stop below 589, targets are 605 and 609. If 609 is crossed, then 612 would be the next target. And Dr. Reddy April Futures is a sell, stop above 2125, target 2089. And finally, Sun TV April Futures, you buy with a stop below 908, 927, and next target would be 935.
Okay. Ashwini, I just want to know, any individual banks that you would trade? I mean, Axis in particular.
See, Axis Bank is weak, so, you know, we can leave that aside. But I think HDFC Bank, Yes Bank, they are both showing strength. So possibly retail lenders like Kotak, HDFC Bank could move on the upside.
Okay. All right, let's cut across to the management of Mindtree, detailing their good set of numbers.
And 4.5% in constant currency terms for the quarter. For the full year, revenues came in at $847 million, which was a growth of 8.6% over the previous year. Mindtree continues to execute very strongly across both our digital as well as run the business programs for our clients, and that strong customer satisfaction is helping us grow faster than the industry. This is the fifth year we are outperforming the industry in a row, industry growth rate, and in 9 out of the last 11 years, we have grown faster than the industry averages. The strong deal wins and the strong revenue momentum also helped helped us a lot in the margin improvement, and this quarter also had good margin improvement there. Ending the year on a very strong note sets us for a very good traction for next year. For FY19, we expect Mindtree to continue to grow faster than the industry, and growth rates in FY19 will be higher than the growth rates in FY18. We expect the year to start on a strong note and expect growth to be even across the four quarters of the year. Our efforts to improve margins continue, and we think margins in FY19 will be better than the margins in FY18. Very strong deal wins in this quarter included today the largest win in the history of Mindtree, where Mindtree was given the entire responsibility for the quality assurance function for one of our existing customers in the US, which is in the airline industry. We also had many other very strong multi-year, multi-million dollar deal wins in this quarter. Another interesting trend that we have started in the financial results that we shared with the media as well as with the investor community yesterday was that for the first time, Mindtree has declared that we have 335 bots as part of the teams that Mindtree has. So we have both a human and a bot team that are creating value for our customers. With that, I'd like to hand over to my colleague Jagan to share other financial highlights.
Thank you, Rostov. Good morning, all. I'm very happy to share that our fee revenue this quarter grew by 5.7% quarter-on-quarter, with a volume growth of 7.8% and the price realization decline of 2.1%. Our EBITDA for the quarter is 16.1%, which is a 100 basis point improvement compared to the last quarter. 70 basis points was due to currency benefit, and 30 basis points was due to operational improvement. Our PAT for the quarter has improved by 200 basis points to 12.4% this quarter. The EPS for the quarter was 11.08, which is again increased from the previous quarter. The total EPS for the year is 34.8 rupees, and this is about 30% growth compared to last year. The Board of Directors in its meeting held on April 18, 2018 has recommended an interim dividend of Rs. 2 per share and a final dividend of Rs. 3 per share, which is subject to the shareholders' approval. The DSO for the quarter has been 67 days, which is a 4 days improvement compared to last quarter. Our EBITDA to operating cash flow is 76% and EBITDA to free cash flow is about 62%. Very strong cash recovery realization from the customers. Now, few points on the outlook for the coming quarters. As mentioned by Rostov, we are expecting strong revenue momentum in financial year 19. With that, we will be able to improve our margin in FY19 compared to FY18. Few points to be kept in considered for this is our salary increment for all Mindtree minds are going to be with effect from April 1st, 2018, which will have about 300 basis point impact on our margin. We are going to hire 1,900 campus minds in FY19. The number of visas we have applied for next year is very minimal, and the impact of visa fees is going to be insignificant. This is on the basis of our strength in hiring in the local market wherever we are present. We also continue to focus on improving the margin in the next year, and we will be able to overall year on year improve the margin for FY19. With this, I conclude my update. Thank you.
Okay, no questions are being taken, so we will get perhaps more from the Mindtree management. The indications are that margins are going to be better in FY19 and they will do better overall in FY19. And you can see that the stock has gained a further 3.5% today after a fairly strong, I mean, doubling of share price in the past 4 months, actually, year to date. That's a fairly strong guidance, positive guidance coming in from the Bindu management. We'll take a break now. It's been a strong showing in equity markets across Asia. India is strong, but clearly underperforming Asia, but nevertheless in the green. This strong showing is coming largely because of the bout of bullishness in commodities. Manisha Gupta is joining us with the first trends in the commodity space. Good morning, Manisha, again.
Thank you for that, Lata. And everything is trading in green in the commodities as a space. The crude oil prices, let's begin with that. And we are holding around fresh 2014 highs onto this one. It has been yet another couple of percentage point gains overnight. And we are up nearly 0.5% in the Asian markets. So that's exactly what we are mirroring. More than 1% gains coming in for the Indian crude oil prices. It has been about the speculative money going net long at record highs for the Brent prices there. And apart from that, there are those supply concerns continuing from Venezuela. The U.S. Reintroducing sanctions on Iran is yet another thing. And we have seen a decline in the U.S. weekly inventories. So all of that clearly has been supportive. Markets, of course, now watching out for the OPEC statements, where the compliance actually has been more than 100% in last 6 months. And there's an expectation that you would see the cuts agreement continue for the rest of 2018 as well. It has been good buying, though, that has come back for the precious metals as a sector. We are holding around 31,500 for gold prices, and silver finally has crossed above 40,000 rupees. It actually has been 2.5% gains and a 3-month highs that we are looking at the silver prices also. It actually has broken above key resistance areas, and there you could be some buying coming in on charts because of that as well. The base metal prices has been a different story altogether. I actually want to focus only on nickel and aluminum. More than 3% gains coming in for both of these metals. And if you look at overnight markets, you have seen nearly 8% gains in nickel and 6% of gain come in for the aluminum prices as well. So it has been very strong strength that you have seen come in for this one. Another thing really is that about aluminum, we have been talking, it has been about U.S. sanctions on Rusal. For nickel also, it has been about Norilsk nickel, and that leads to supply concerns going forward. We have seen 12% gains come in for the nickel prices in this week itself, and aluminum is up 25% in this month alone. And that clearly seems to be rubbing off into other metals, where you are looking at copper prices trading at a 1-month highs, zinc is trading at a 3-month highs as well, and you have seen all the other metals like iron ore prices, which are up 4.5% in Shanghai right now. That one is trading at a 1-month highs. So metals as a pack is something that you need to keep an eye on. Very, very strong fundamentals and a lot of volume, money being shifted into this sector as well. And that just takes the rally that much more credible. But buying strategies is what we have on crude oil, and that one is coming in from Grow Value. They have a buy on crude oil. 4560 is their upside target for today. It continues to be the energy sector, and natural gas is their next pick, and 190 rupees per MMBTU is what they are looking for those prices.
Okay.